It's still a bit strange for me doing this really kind of personal stuff, because for the first 30 years of, as a chiller the stockbroker, I've been out there ranting about the world and the social justice and doing silly stuff about football and dirty sleeping bags. But I've always just written about what happened to me and what the world that was happening in the world, and that's been happening, so I've been writing about it. And it means a lot to me to be able to do stuff like that. You know, and there's more actually, but I'm not going to do any more now. I'm going to go back to more of the kind of what you might say the more traditional stockbroker material. And this one is about spam. Now spam, for people of my age, used to be pink and come in tins, and was made out of the dangly bits of indeterminate furry creatures, and it was absolutely disgusting, and obviously became even more disgusting when soaked in cold fat for a week and then served up as spam fritters for school dinners. Did you know that you could buy pre-packed spam fritters in the supermarket? My wife found some not long ago. I couldn't believe it, but you can. Anyway, of course, now you're just getting in your inbox. And I'm really a really bit of a Luddite with computers, so I attempted to delete the spam using a spam filter, but it simply deleted everything that I wanted as well. So I now delete them one by one manually, and I've written this poem about them. This is the spam harvest of about 2008, when this book was produced. But of course, there's cycles of spam, and it comes and goes. But it's the themes are very similar. This is called "Oh for the Days When Spam Was Just a Monty Python Sketch." Thanks to the internet, my wife is a very happy woman. My penis is now 47 feet long, stays erect for weeks at a time, and is garlanded by hundreds of genuine Rolex watches, acquired with the millions I have won in various Albanian lotteries, and the billions generously deposited in my accounts by the grateful executives of the wills of innumerable African tribal chiefs, or mysteriously deceased along with their entire extended families in improbably gruesome lawnmower accidents in Liechtenstein. My account with Lloyds has been suspended. I don't have one. My wife's breasts enlarge and reduce spontaneously as we use our 95% discounted software to gaze at the pictures of our free timeshare apartments, enjoying continuous multiple orgasms while admiring our genuine Chinese historical artifacts purchased online from Hong Kong. Our garden is full of imported rubber. Not even rubber sex toys or rubber boots, just rubber. I have more free Coldplay MP3s than you could wave a suicide note at. I also have Kate Moss suction power. I don't know what that is, but I'm hoping it may be useful next time the toilet needs unblocking. I know that the Cyrillic alphabet and the Polish form. I'm embarrassed about your size. Every morning, a new surrealist word juxtaposition appears in my inbox as the spammers seek to avoid the filter. Applicator fornicate. Crab meat be Paris. Gash ineptitude. Out evoke in Robbins. Consonant clitoris. Bestiality service charge. Decomposing lark's vomit in Gulf Crystal Palace. Okay, I made the last one up. But all the others are genuine. And to prove that truth is indeed stranger than fiction in our brave new world, my website is recommended as one of the top 50 stockbroking sites on many search engines. Now that really is Python. Thank you.